I've been living on the west coast, trying to call, keep it in a friend zone. But some nights drinking, we get too close. Is it goodbye or hello? Pulling over on the freeway, sunset tripping over LA. Your fly tripping on a delay. Is it goodbye or hello? Hello, hello, hello.
Good morning, my beautiful people. Today is a very special day. Finally got into the Arcadia Invitational. Although not in the Invitational section as I would have hoped, I got into the Burning Baton session. I'm gonna be running the 3200 meters at around 7:45 in heat two. I'm gonna shoot for just as close as I can to that 9-minute barrier, trying to even break the 9-minute barrier just to set a new school record. As it is, I ran 9:20 at the Covina Invitational. I'm gonna go all out. And right now it's currently 8:50 in the morning. I just got here at school like 20 minutes ago and I don't have a first period, so I'm gonna take advantage of that and do a quick 10-minute shakeout, just nice and easy to, you know, get the blood flowing and, you know, hopefully get that lactate out of my legs from yesterday's race. We had a league meet at Rim of the World High School. As far as competitors go, main people that I'm looking for and trying to follow are Joshua Razzo from Walnut and also Bill Issa from West Ranch. So it's gonna be a good race for sure. Main thing is gonna be not going out too hard and just finish like under 65. But ultimately, as long as I'm averaging 67s, I'm happy. And yeah, it's gonna be a fun one. And then the next week we have Mount Sac Relays where I get to hit the 3200 again. So we'll keep you posted. And yeah, so let's get the shakeout in. Peace. Shakeout completed. Just a nice easy 10 minutes and then just like sprinted the last bit, just get used to that race pace. So nothing too crazy, and right now it's 9:10, so we're just gonna go back to school. I'm gonna do a little bit of, you know, rolling out and band stretches, but other than that it's gonna be an easy day and then just honing in. And I'm probably gonna take a nap during fifth period because I have yoga, and so yeah, I'm gonna take it nice and easy today. I need to finish some Spanish homework and that's it. You know, that's the only thing really pending. Other than that, it's gonna be an easy day. It's gonna be a great day. So, see you later. Okay, what's up, my beautiful people? Just got out of school and now just waiting to get picked up by my coach so we can head out, have some lunch, and then get to the Arcadia Invitational. So just finished the warm-up jog, easy 5 minutes.
Looked pretty good, looked pretty good.
Thank you. Okay, so here with my main man, Justin. So yeah, right now we only got, not too much time.
20 minutes before race time.
Basically.
Well,
it's enough time, barely.
Technically 30, because you have the first heat.
Yeah.
Or Or wait, you're in heat three, aren't you?
Two. Yeah, so I'm going
right after you. What the dog doing?
I want that first mile to be exactly 440 or maybe slightly under. Mm-hmm. And then just hitting it hard in the second mile and kicking it home. That last lap has to be, you know, ideally, you know, under 65. At least that's what I'm shooting for. So the goal of time, at least 9:11 or under. But I'm going to shoot for that, you know, just under a 9-minute barrier. So yeah, right now I'm stupidly sweaty. It is so hot right now. So we'll see you.
That race is 926,
912 for the win. Section 2 on the track. Can you see the run again here? I feel like new sunglasses, like a brand new pair of jeans. I feel like taking chances. I feel a lot like 17. Like when I close my eyes and don't even care if anyone sees me dancing. Like I can fly and don't even think of touching the ground. Like a heartbeat skip, like an open page, like a one-way trip on an aeroplane. It's the way that I feel when I'm with you. Brand new.
Finished the race. It was a PR for me. 9:17. How about you, man? How you feeling?
Feeling a little disappointed. I dropped out. You know, like I think with like 600 meters left, I dropped out. But I think it's just a mental block. But you know, it's not the end of the world. Still got the rest of the season.
Still got Mount Sac too.
Yes, sir. Got Mount Sac.
You want to drop the Insta?
Yeah, follow me, Matthew Donis, on Instagram, MATTHEWDONIS.
Oh, yeah. Rocked it, man. Really pushing the pace there.
Yeah, thank you, bro.
What's going on in the life, man?
Not much, just training, school, stuff like that.
For sure.
Just getting that work in and hopefully qualify for state.
All I could really think about is about just how much I really want it. You know what I'm saying? Like, running is kind of my favorite thing. You know, it makes my day every day. And during those hard times, you know, after Arcadia and after Masters, you know, especially after Masters, I just knew I had to keep going. And I knew that, you know, I had a lot of people supporting me and, you know, people look up to me, and you know, I knew that it wasn't just about me, it was about, you know, all of y'all who support me and stuff. And so, you know, it just forced me to push through the pain and, you know, overcome it and overcome bad races. You know, after Arcadia, I came back, dropped 9:05, you know, just off of you know, having belief in myself and in my training. And you know, the support, all the support that I get definitely pushes me. And yeah, I feel like I've gotten to the point where, you know, my running isn't just about me. It's about representing the AV, that's where I'm from, and representing all my fans. You know, all these people believe in me, so why should I let a little ankle sprain stop me from competing in the state meet. You know, all these people like give me love and like attention, and it just motivates me to train harder. And yeah, to summarize it all up, the thing that got me to overcome, you know, bad races and injury from masters was to just take a step back, you know, come back to earth for a little bit and just look around and notice how much people actually like care about me and actually like support what I'm doing. So that's what got me to push after Arcadia, and that's what got me to push at state, although I didn't go to plan because of my ankle.
For sure, man.
Yeah.
We got you, man.
Yeah.
Stay safe.
Thank you, bro. Okay. Yeah.
Guys, I met Mohammed and I got a signature. I'm just kidding. They just had autograph cards, but I have his signature. Oh, yeah. But yeah, we just finished up the race. It meant all the difference just having the whole team out here. At least my main inspiration that really, you know, like I gotta like tell you, man, like honestly, I still reminisce on the middle school miles, bro. You, me, and Victor.
I was thinking about that when you were racing. I was like, damn,
dude. Bro. Like, from getting smoked every day, dude. You guys literally made my middle school experience. I'm like, you guys got a special place in my heart for you. And I'm not just saying this because, like, I'm gonna edit this out. But you know, like, for real, I'm here today because of you, Victor.
Remember when you weren't gonna do cross because of Van?
Yeah, yeah.
That was crazy.
You guys were a godsend. Oh god.
I was like, you had so much potential running. I'm like, dude, you guys did this.
Dude, I wish I would have done it sooner. I think overall it was a successful night. It was a PR. If either case, you know, we got Mount Sac next week. This is awesome. Then we have all of CIF, so you know, there's more to come. More to come. Yo, so want to tell the vlog what's going on in your life, man? Like, how's Cop Holly? How's the family? You know, what's the career goal right now?
History teacher.
History teacher still? Hell yeah.
Yeah, bro, I'm sticking with it.
You got
just the... chilling right now, just, you know, keeping up the gym, running here and there.
I might drop the Insta here. We just got home.
He just got home. And this fool, typo. Show the typo.
Del La Torre.
Del. It's Del La Torre, not Del Taco, dumbass. I mean,
Well, I'll bleep that out.
Yeah, no, don't bleep that out. Let's restart that.
Mirelo?
It's Del La Torre, not Del Taco. What is wrong with y'all?
But yeah.
My lips look sexy. Oh, not kidding.
They do. Hi, Cheekies.
What?
Hello.
Don't agree.
How you doing?
Hey, show Alex. Where the camera?
What the dog doing?
It's gonna look cool one of these days.
Let's
start recording.
Bueno, pues les presento a mi mamá. Hola, ¿cómo estás, ma?
Bien.
That's awesome.
Barcelona.
Cueritos. Anyway, Liz, you want to say something to the vlog?
Yes.
What do you want to say?
Good.
Good? What was the highlight of the day?
Well, it wasn't really a highlight. I was just mad at this because, like, my teacher didn't grade the multiplication test.
No. Really?
Yeah. But, I mean, she had to take a break because she always, like, does it on Thursday and then, like,
on Friday.
I'm in PJs.
That's wonderful. You look very pretty. Well, even then, you know how that now you're in your 11s now? Your times tables, yeah? How's that going? How do you feel about math right now?
I kind of don't like math. That's one thing. In my opinion, I don't really like math. It's just...
Low-key, me neither. But I'm doing calculus, which is weird.
I like literacy more because I get to read much and like do like writing. And mostly what we're learning about is like Egypt, which was fun fact. They rode camels, and camels are really hard to ride because they go up and down, because it's like, I don't know, it's just something that camels do. But also, in Egypt, they were the first one to make bodies into mummified, but also because they thought if they wrap it around, their bodies would stay how they are and don't turn into dust. And they thought they would come back to life. People from Egypt, they thought they were coming back to life, but they never actually did. Yeah. Well, at least they conserved the body inside bandages. I forgot what the name is, but it started with a C.
Sarcophagus?
No.
Well, that's wonderful. Thank you for telling us that story. What's something that you want to tell future you? You know, when she comes back and sees the vlog, like, what's something you want to tell yourself future, like, to your future self?
Get more interested into math, honestly.
Yeah? I feel like you'd be an excellent mathematician or engineer.
Thank you.
We'll see. We'll let you know. Future Lizzie, you're awesome.
And
you're gonna, you are awesome now, and you're gonna be more awesome later. We love you, Lizzie.
Thank you.
Estamos cenando tostadas de la abuela.
Okay. Bueno, pues, buenas noches.